The Japanese State Minister for Foreign Affairs, Kazuyuki Nakane, is to arrive in Sri Lanka today and will be here till the 30th of August in order to participate in the commissioning ceremony of the patrol vessels donated from Japan to Sri Lanka under the grant aid of the Government of Japan to be held tomorrow at the Colombo Port. This is the second time a high-ranking official of the Japanese government arrived in Sri Lanka in the span of a week.
In addition, during his stay, Minister Nakane will call on Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe and hold meetings with other Sri Lankan government leaders to further promote bilateral relationships between the two countries. The Japanese Embassy in Sri Lanka says it expects that this visit would help further consolidate the comprehensive partnership between Japan and Sri Lanka. The two patrol vessels will be handed over to Sri Lanka Coast Guard to improve maritime safety and strengthen control of the maritime borders of the island. The vessels will be used mainly for search and rescue, pollution control and oil spill management, as well as maritime security boarding operations. The vessels were built in Japan under the grant aid of the Government of Japan and cost over $11 million in total. International media reported Japanese maritime security expert Satoru Nagao saying there is a Japanese-Sri Lankan project for maritime safety capability improvement worth approximately 1.8 billion yen or $16.5 million, which includes the provision of two patrol vessels for the Sri Lankan Coast Guard. International media adds that the first ever visit of the Japanese Defense Minister Itsunori Onodera to Sri Lanka earlier this week was of great significance to the Indian Ocean region. A Japanese naval destroyer was in the Trincomalee harbour when the Japanese Defence Minister Onodera was visiting it. Close on the heels of the visit of the Japanese Defence Minister to Trincomalee, the US amphibious transport dock USS Anchorage, along with the 13th Marine Expeditionary Unit MEU, arrived there for a scheduled port visit on the 24th of August. In his report to the Pathfinder Foundation, former Sri Lankan Navy Chief Admiral Colombage says, analyzing the country of origin of foreign warships visiting the port of Colombo from 2008 to 2017, it is observed that 65 Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force ships had arrived in Sri Lankan ports, mainly the port of Colombo. India's BJP leader, Dr. Subramaniam Swamy, on his arrival to Sri Lanka last week, speaking to the Veerakesari newspaper, had spoken about the importance of countries like India having the opportunity of carrying out commercial activities in a similar manner to China. Why is there increased international attention towards strategic locations of our country?
China is heavily investing in ports and port cities along the maritime Silk Route especially. So you would see development in Singapore, you see development mainly in Kairuk Fu in Burma. Then you can see developments in Sri Lanka, Hambantota and Port City, and then all the way up towards Gwadar in Pakistan. And there is connectivity that China is looking at even through in Middle East, in the Emirate like Dubai. So what you see in the Indian Ocean is a clear strategic concern which is rising from China's One Belt, One Road. So what you see clearly is a 3 to 4 to 5 way contestation between the US, India, Japan, Australia to have a major stake in the geopolitical future of the Indian Ocean, especially in the light that China is expanding heavily in the region. So as a country, Sri Lanka is facing significant challenges in balancing this intense geopolitical rivalry. And you can see that in Sri Lanka in the last few years, you see so much of interest on our country, but not just from India or China, but from the US. And very recently, you saw a couple of major high-level visits by key Japanese statesmen in Sri Lanka. In the next 5 to 10 years, Sri Lanka will have to weather a major geopolitical storm.
Are these foreign interventions a result of weaknesses in our own government?